Which one do you think is a genuine certificate? Is it the one on the left or the right? I am Sandeep P. Gaukar, and I'm here to talk about something that is revolutionizing the way we share our achievements, verifiable credentials. If you are unable to identify the original certificate, don't worry, you are not alone. Today, with advanced design tools, it has become very easy to replicate any certificate designs. And this is why we should opt for verifiable credentials. If you're wondering what verifiable credentials are, they are basically digital proofs that you are who you say you are and that you have what you say you have. More about it in a while. Let's go back in time to see how credentials have evolved. In the Middle Ages, seals were more than just decoratives. They were essential tools for validating documents, recognizing authors, and ensuring the integrity of the content. A wax seal on a parchment guaranteeing that no one's tampering with the message inside. Seals had three main functions. They guaranteed secrecy, indicated ownership, and most importantly, authenticated the written act. As trade expanded, so did the use of seals. City seals became indispensable for validating transactions and contracts. Trading companies relied heavily on seals to certify their documents. And let's not forget the medieval church. Bishops, popes, and monasteries used seals to mark their influence and authority, giving us a rich tapestry of ecclesiastical seal usage. Then came the seal rings. Skilled metalworkers crafted gold or bronze rings featuring the owner's name or monogram. These rings were used to authenticate documents, turning the seal into a proof of authenticity. But as population grew, the reliance on handwritten documents and signature increased. Signatures became the go-to method for authenticating documents until scammers started forging them. This led to a need for a more secure method of validation. The digital revolution of 1980s had a profound impact on society, laying the groundwork for the information age. The widespread adoption of PCs, the growth of internet, advancement in digital media and communication technologies transformed the way people worked, communicated, and entertained. In 1991, Adobe co-founder Dr. John Warnock launched the Camelot project, aiming to transfer paper document into a digital one. The goal was to enable anyone to capture document from any application, to send electronic version anywhere and view and print them on any machine. And thus, the PDF was born. For a long time, PDFs were non-editable, serving as secure electronic documents. But with advancement in software, we can now edit through PDFs seamlessly. And today, in the age of AI, with trained GPT models, it's easier than ever to generate, edit, and even fake documents, bringing both innovation and new challenges. And this is where blockchain technology comes to rescue. For those who are unfamiliar, blockchain technology is the same technology behind cryptocurrency. But instead of money, it can be used to store secure and verifiable records, like your qualification, work experience, or even a short-term course. So, how is PDF document different from a verifiable document? You see, PDF document is a file format that allows users to share and present documents without worrying about the software, hardware, or the operating system which has been used. The layout and format will always remain the same as the original file. A verifiable document, on the other hand, also has the same presentation layer, which is PDF. And the crucial data of the credential are anchored to the blockchain. Not just data, but an entire document can be anchored to the blockchain. Let's understand this with an example. Let's say a birth certificate. Think of this as a template with fixed and variable fields. The fixed elements are part of template itself and don't change. Whereas the variable fields like name, date, time, gender, and address will change based on whom you are issuing it to. So, every time a birth registrar issues a credential, the variable data gets anchored to the blockchain to create a proof, and the PDF document itself will get a cryptographic hash. Now, because of this, machine can verify these credentials very easily. These blockchain credentials are essentially digital certificates that live on a decentralized network. This means they are tamper-evident, can't be lost, and are always accessible to you. Think about it. No more hunting down old diplomas or worrying about forgeries. With blockchain credential, you have complete control over who sees them and can easily share them with potential employers, educational institutes, or anyone who needs to verify your skill. For example, I have a verifiable credential that says I'm a product guy at DeWay. And I also have one that says I'm a great neurosurgeon. Just kidding. Don't take my words for it. Just look at the QR code on the screen and scan it with your phone. Trust me, you will be able to verify my credentials yourself. You might have experienced this many times, right? You scan a QR code on a printed certificate and it redirects you to a digital version of the document. Sorry to say, but that's not called as verifiable document. To call a credential verifiable, you need five things. Proof that this credential is issued by a specific organization. It should show the status of the credential. That is it active? Has it been expired, or has it been revoked by the issuer? Proof of whom it has been issued to. Proof of date and timestamp. Proof that the data mentioned in the certificate can be trusted. Guess what? With blockchain, all of the above mentioned points are possible. By the way, at the start of this conversation, did you identify which certificate is genuine and which one is fake? Guess what? Both of them were fake. In the next few years, due to AI, it would be very difficult to find the original certificates out of thousands of fake certificates. In my next video, I'll show you how exactly you can create a verifiable credentials for your students, staff, or employees. By issuing blockchain credentials, you are ensuring that holders receive a tamper-resistant credentials and your company reputation is not misused by scammers. Do you think organizations should adopt to verifiable credentials? Have you faced problems while verifying a document? Please share your thoughts and experience in comments. Follow me for more such interesting content. See you soon.